Hello friends, if you like my videos, subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.
So students, in this video we are going to discuss about clonarthritis. So clonarthritis is also a parasitic disease. So we are going to learn about the clonarthritis and the cause of this clonarthritis and even the symptoms which you can see in a person who is infected with this disease called as clonarthritis. So this clonarthritis is mainly caused by a fluke called as clonarthritis sinensis. Right, it is mainly caused by a trematode called as clonarthritis sinensis, and it is a scientific name where it is commonly called as Chinese fluke, or else it is also called as Oriental liver fluke. So I am going to name here as a liver fluke for my convenience. Okay, so it is commonly called as Oriental liver fluke or else Chinese fluke. And why it is named as liver fluke actually? Because it causes damages in the liver part of the human beings. Once it enter into the human beings through contaminated food, then what will happen? Then the part of the liver will get damaged. I mean the bile, you know about the bile duct, right? Which is present in the liver, which secretes the bile juice. So that part will get damaged in the liver, which causes in the human beings. So then you can say that the person is infected with clonarthritis disease. So how it enters into the human beings and how it causes damage to the liver, and what is the life cycle of this clonarthritis sinensis, each and everything will be discussed now. So now let us learn about the life cycle of clonarthritis sinensis. So now let us discuss about the life cycle of clonarthritis sinensis, which is also called as liver fluke, which causes the disease called as clonarthritis. So let us assume this is a human being and we are considered this human being as a definitive host, right? Let us consider this human being as a definitive host, and let us also consider that this human being is infected with clonarthritis. So as he is infected with clonarthritis, this body contains liver flukes, which is also called as clonarthritis sinensis. Okay, so as this body contains liver flukes, then it will releases eggs, right? So now what will happen is that this human being will go near to the pond or else near to the lake and will excrete his waste material called as fecals in that lake, right? Or else in that pond. Okay, then what will happen? Now we know that the eggs are also present in the digestive system, right? And that eggs will be released along with the fecals, and it will be released in the water because he will excrete his waste material in the water, right? So the fecals will get released into the water which contains the embryonated eggs, right? And remember, this embryonated eggs belongs to liver fluke, right? So now what will happen? We know that the water, the snails are present in the water, right? So what will happen? Now the snails will start feeding upon this fecus material, but we know that this fecus material contains the embryonated eggs of liver fluke, which has been excreted from the fecus material of human beings, right? Now what will happen? Now the snails will consume this fecus material which contains the embryonated eggs. So now what will happen in the snails? And don't forget to remember, the snails is considered as intermediate host. It is a primary intermediate host, right? So now what will happen in the snails? So remember, this embryonated eggs will enter into the snails and it will enter into the digestive system of the snail. So we know that the digestive system contains digestive juices, right? Which are acidic in nature. So now what will happen? Then the eggs will get hatched. The hatching will be done to the eggs. Now once the eggs will get hatched, then what will happen? Then the miracidia which is present in that egg will be released, right? So this is the miracidia which will be released from the egg once it undergoes the process of hatching, right? So how the hatching will be done? Because of the digestive juices which are present in the digestive system of the snail, right? So now this miracidia will undergo the process of metamorphosis and will get developed into sporocyst, and now this sporocyst will get developed into ridia. And remember, ridia is also one type of fluke where it contains sporocyst, right? Now that sporocyst will get broken down such that the sarcaria which is present inside it will get protruded out, right? So now finally the sarcaria will be developed, and all of this process will be occurred in the digestive system of the snail itself, right? So from the embryonated egg, the miracidia will be protruded out by the hatching process, and now this miracidia will get finally developed into sarcaria, right? So this is what you have to know, which will occur in the intermediate host, the digestive system of the intermediate host called as snail. So finally from the snail, what will happen? The sarcaria will get developed, right? Now this sarcaria will get excreted from this snail. I mean, the snail will also exhibit the fecus material, right? And from that fecus material, the sarcaria will get protruded out, right? And now the sarcaria will be free in form in the water. And now what will happen? All of this sarcaria which is present in the water will be consumed by the fishes which are present in the water. Exactly, right? And now we are going to consider this fish as a secondary intermediate host. So snail is considered as primary intermediate host or else first intermediate host, and you are considered this fish as secondary intermediate host, right? And now what will happen? We know that the human beings will consume these fishes, and once if the fish is uncooked properly, right, it is not cooked properly, then what will happen? Then the fish which contains this cercaria will enter into the stomach of this human being. Then this human being will get infected with clonarches. So once this fish has been consumed, then the cercaria will also enter into the stomach, right? Because it is uncooked properly, right? So now what will happen in the case of these human beings? So now the cercaria has been entered into the stomach. We know that the stomach consists of gastric juices which are acidic in nature, right? So now what will happen, you know, here normally the cercaria, the surface of the body cercaria consists of cyst wall, right? And the cyst wall, along with the cyst wall, the cercaria will enter into the stomach, which contains the gastric juices which are acidic in nature. So what will happen, you know, the cyst wall will get ruptured and it will be released out, you know, it will get protruded out from the cercaria, and now that cercaria will get developed into metacercaria, right? So now this metacercaria, within 1 to 2 days, it will enter into the bile ducts. I mean, it will enter into the part of the liver. So we know that the bile ducts releases bile juices. We know that the liver will produce the bile juices, right, from the bile ducts. So now what will happen, you know, this metacercaria, which has been reached towards this bile ducts, will consume that bile juices which are released by the bile ducts, right? So this metacercaria will consume the bile juices which are released by the bile ducts in the liver. So due to that consumption, what will happen, you know, it will get developed into adult flukes. Right, because it will consume, bile ducts will produce the bile juices continuously. So now what will happen, this metacercaria will consume that bile juices continuously, such that this metacercaria will get developed into adult fluke soon, right? And remember, this is one of the most important thing which you people have to remember. So what is that? Adult fluke, the survival capacity of the adult fluke is 30 years. So this is the lifespan of the adult fluke. Okay, so now this adult fluke also has a capacity to produce 4000 eggs per day. Right, it releases 4000 eggs per day, and then it will again enter back into the digestive system, and then it will be released again with the fecus material, right, along with the fecus material, and that fecus material contains embryonated eggs which has been released by the adult fluke. Exactly right. And now again the total life cycle will get repeated, where the snails will consume this fecus material which contains the embryonated eggs, and that embryonated eggs will enter into the digestive system of the snail, right, which is called as a primary intermediate host or as the first intermediate host. Now, once the hatching of the egg will be done, then what will happen? Then the miracidia will get protruded out from that eggs due to hatching process. And again, the total development process will be done, such that the cercaria will get completely developed. And now that cercaria will be free in form, because it will start migrating in the water. And now what will happen, the cercaria will get consumed by the fishes, and now the fishes will be consumed by the human beings, and again the total life cycle will get repeated, right? So here the three most important things which you people have to remember is that here the humans are considered as definitive host, and the snails are considered as primary intermediate host or as the first intermediate host, and the fishes are considered as secondary intermediate host or as it is also considered as second intermediate host, right? So this is the life cycle of Clonarches sinensis, which causes a disease called as clonarches. So now let us learn about the symptoms which can be seen in the person who is infected with this parasitic disease called as clonarches. So some of the common symptoms which you can see in that person who is infected with this clonarches is fever, chills, anorexia, diarrhea, epigastric pain, abdominal pain, hepatomegaly, mild headache. So these are the common symptoms which you can see in a person who is infected with this parasitic disease called as clonarches. So what is the parasite which is involved here? Liver fluke. So what is the scientific name of that liver fluke? Clonarches sinensis, right? So this is about the life cycle of Clonarches sinensis, and if you like this video, subscribe our channel, and if you have any doubts regarding this topic, you can comment in the comment box. We are going to clarify your doubts immediately. Thank you.